Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica. Happy 2021, and today's video, we're gonna do the introduction for my 2021 Pan That Palette. This will be my fourth year doing Pan That Palette. My very first year was a Marc Jacobs palette. The second year was the ABH Subculture palette. The third year was Blood Sugar. If you missed that, I will have that up in the cards, the whole playlist, and this year. We are finally tackling some of the most expensive makeup in my collection. That is right, I am panning a Natasha Denona palette, and the palette that I'm going to be panning in 2021 is the Lila palette. I feel like halfway through 2020, I was actually working on my HP project pan, and I had a Natasha palette in there. And after working with it and hitting pan a couple of times and like really liking the formula and the looks I was getting, I realized I really wanted to pan a Natasha palette. The trouble was, I was stuck between like two or three palettes. I thought about Metropolis. I'm like, oh, that's still too new. I don't know. Thought about Sunset. I really wanted to do Sunset because it was kind of sentimental to me, but it's really warm toned. And I just did Blood Sugar, which was like super warm toned. And I realized I've done a neutral palette for Pan That Palette. I did a grungy rainbow kind of palette. I did a really red palette. I've never really done purples. And I know this is still, it's got neutrals in here, but this is a very purpley pink palette, and I think it's going to be a perfect challenge for me. And the goal for this Pan That palette, I really do want to do the traditional Pan That palette and use up the whole palette. Ooh, I think it's going to be a challenge, like I said, whew, but I'm excited. So let's zoom in for the first shot. Alright, so this is the palette right here, trying to remove the reflect from the ring light, but I did rearrange my shadows. If you didn't know, if you have any of the Natasha palettes in this packaging, they're super easy, they're magnetic, to just pop out and rearrange. So I did rearrange this palette. I kept kind of the bright shimmers down here on the bottom. I put all the matte neutral shades on the top, and then everything else I just kind of put in the middle row. I was thinking about how I wanted this to be arranged for a year-long project pan, and this is just what made the most sense to me. As you can see, I've got some wear in here, but to be honest, this is my least used Natasha palette. So we do have a couple of random, like, pop of, like, warm tones in here, but overall, this is going to be a cool-toned palette and a purple challenge, purpley-pinky challenge for me. For my first month, I don't really want to put like a goal out there just because I really try to save it. So I'm wearing like one of the shades, like I'm wearing this shade just to deepen out the outer corner. The rest of my eye today is this Tom Ford eye color that I received in PR through Influencer. This is the eye cream and powder eye color in the shade Golden Peach from Tom Ford. So I have that on everywhere, and then I just have this first shade right here just to deepen out the outer and then on my lower lash line, and that's about it. For me, I've had this palette in my everyday makeup basket for a couple of weeks now, but I've been doing my best to not really reach for it. That sounds kind of silly, but I really wanted to just like look at the palette, try to get some inspiration from the palette, because for my Pan That palettes, I really try to wait until like actually January of the year to start really using the palette. So it's a real traditional, like you have 12 months, finish the palette kind of challenge. So I did like one or two looks throughout December with this palette, but I really just wanted to keep my hands off of it until now. So now that I've got the introduction, my first thing that I like to do with Pan That palettes is look up tutorials, do some eye looks, get real creative, and spend the first month just getting used to the palette. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. So I'm very excited. I really I'm like half and half with Natasha Denona because I really like the shadows, but they're so expensive and I don't think they're worth the price. And I have the Sunset has like a special place, like it's sentimental to me because I wanted it for so long and I saved up for like 8 months to get it and I finally got it. This Lila one, I had the money and it was like, I think my second Natasha palette. And I got it because it was like right when it first came out, getting rave reviews, everyone loved it. Everyone did like videos on it and then it disappeared within like a month or two. And I really don't see many people using this with the exception of, who's using it? Lauren May Beauty uses this palette. She does actually use this palette in her collection. So I'm gonna look up a couple of her videos for inspiration and tutorials. But yeah, so I feel like this is my least used Natasha palette. I wanna get more use out of it. And now I'm gonna challenge myself to pan this entire thing in 2021. This is also going to be the last video you'll see in this room, my cute little attic room. I'm actually getting sentimental and kind of sad about it. I think I've lived in this house, in this room, for the longest amount of time that I've lived anywhere. Because, well, I was a military brat, so I grew up constantly, like, moving places. I never really lived anywhere for longer than, I think, 4 years. And then once I was a teenager, we moved from New Mexico to North Carolina, and then we moved a couple times to North Carolina, and then I went to boarding school, so I moved then. I had to move every year in boarding school. I then went to college, moved every year in college, and then after college is when I moved here, and I've been here since 2015. Oof, I think it was February 2015, so like just under, so it's actually, I don't know if it's 5 or 6 years, but I've been here the longest, so I am getting a little bit sentimental about this room, but I'm really, really excited to be moving. Actually, the day that this goes up will be my move-in day, so I will be in my new apartment at this point with my boyfriend, and I'm really excited to get a new setup and just reorganize everything and have videos for you guys to watch. So that is one thing. I am hoping that after this video, with my normal schedule, my Wednesday, Friday, Sunday schedule, that hopefully the next video after this will be moving vlog number 2, I believe. But because I am moving and everything's gonna be kind of crazy, I would just ask to be a little bit patient just as we get everything settled, because I am just pre-filming up until this point. This is the last pre-filmed video, so it might just be a little bit longer before I can get the next moving vlog or the next video up for you guys. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below if you're going to be panning a palette in 2021, and if you are, what palette you're going to be panning. Thank you guys for watching, and I cannot wait to see you in my new space and in my next video. Bye.